How can you figure out God's plan for your life? In this video, I'm going to give you 3 pointers on how your desires can actually help you figure out what God wants you to do with your life. Hey everyone, I'm Mark from ApplyGodsWord.com. I'm making new videos just like this every single week, so make sure you tap that subscribe button before this video ends, so every time I make a new video, you get a little notification. So the first thing I want to talk about is that our desires are actually a good signpost for where God might want us to go in our life when it comes to our calling and our purpose and just what God actually wants us to do. So that's point number one. If you want to know what God wants you to do, you have to look at your desires. Now, that might just sound like totally unbiblical to some of you. You'd be like, what are you talking about? You know, we're sinful. We have all these bad desires. So how can you tell us just to look at our desires? And that's absolutely right. I'm not talking about sinful desires or just saying, hey, whatever you want to do is exactly what God is telling you to do. However, desire reveals design. Okay, so when God puts a design into one of his creations, then that creation is going to have certain desires that correspond with that design. And so, for example, you know, when you just look at certain animals, they do different things and they naturally do those things because they've been designed in different ways. And while I'm not just, you know, equating humans with animals, I'm just talking about a bigger principle that our Creator has designed each and every one of us, and thus we're each going to have certain desires. So when God gives you a certain gift, you are going to have a desire towards using that gift in a way that's different than someone who doesn't have that gift. They're not going to have that desire. So if maybe you have the gift of teaching, you're going to want to teach. If you don't want to ever teach and you're like, that is so boring to me, I hate having to learn and teach and it's just so stressful and I would never want to do that, that God's probably not telling you to do that because you probably don't have that specific gift. But if you have a desire to serve or to be, you have the gift of hospitality, you're actually going to enjoy using that gift. So one of the things you're going to want to look at is your desire. And just as a quick point of emphasis, I got that phrase desire reveals design from a different person named John Eldridge. He has some good material on calling and desires and things like that. So I just wanted to give him a little bit of credit because that one little phrase desire reveals design is something that I learned from John Eldridge. The second tip I have for you, if you're trying to figure out what God's purpose for you is, maybe what you're calling, what does God actually want you to do with your life? The second point is to do what you can't do without. So in other words, what's that one thing or that category in life that you just can't not do? Like that's the thing that you just do naturally, even if like no one's watching or, you know, it's just always something that you end up doing. That's a good sign that God has put a strong desire on your heart. And I think one verse that really captures what I'm trying to say here is in 1 Corinthians 9, verse 16. And Paul says, "Woe to me if I do not preach the gospel." That's what Paul said about himself. Woe to me if I do not preach the gospel. So as we all know, Paul clearly had a calling, and God's purpose for Paul was to empower him to preach the gospel. And clearly you see there that Paul had a strong desire to preach the gospel. He said, "Woe is me." And I think that when you want to know what your calling is, you will end up saying that if you don't end up doing your calling. Like, woe is me if I don't help people in this blank area. And when you can fill in that blank, then I think you're on the right track. So again, point two is focus on trying to do what you can't do without. What's that thing that you naturally are going to do and you just can't live without doing that thing? And finally, point three, seek the Lord with all your heart and be humble enough to let him sanctify and transform your desires. So while I totally support what I talked about in point one and point two about our desires, point three is just humbly submitting and saying our desires aren't fully shaped yet. You know, you're going to continue to grow with the Lord as you seek him, and you have to allow him to shape and mold that desire. So you shouldn't expect to know your whole life plan at the age of 25. You shouldn't expect to know your whole life plan at any age, really. You should always accept that the more you come into the presence of God, the more you try to please him, the more God's desires will become your desires, and your desires will transform over time. So a lot of times you might want something in the beginning or early on in your life, but as the years go by, God will shape and mold that desire into something that looks a lot different than you expected. And that's really something you have to watch out for. So point three, like, how do you know your desire? How can you figure out your calling? Really, you want to seek the Lord so that he will transform you into what he wants. It's kind of a paradigm shift in saying, rather than asking God to make you into that thing you think you want right now, the better thing to do is to seek God and allow him to turn you into whatever he wants. And when he does that, he'll transform your desires, and you'll know he's transforming you through what you'll want to do. So again, when you seek God and you try to make his desires your desires, he's going to put his desires on your heart, and your desires will change. For example, Saul, when he was Saul, before he became Paul, would not have wanted to preach the gospel, right? He was persecuting the church. He was just totally rejecting Jesus. And he could never have imagined, hey, in 20 years, I'm going to want to preach the gospel. But over time, he had that one huge moment where Christ transformed him and revealed himself, and Paul had turned from his sin and became a Christian. But over that time, Paul totally changed, and God gave him a different desire to preach the gospel. Even in my own life, in a very practical way, when I was younger, I was like 19, trying to figure out what God wants me to do. And we all have to go to college, and we think, oh, you know, I have to know my whole life plan and pick my degree when I'm this young adult. Like, so I'm like, well, I like teaching. So I went to school to be a middle school teacher, and I graduated, got my undergrad in education, and my first year of teaching was terrible. I do not like have the gift of working with small children. So I was like, wow, this was really confusing. And so as I was in that season of life, I was going to a church and I felt the call into ministry. And so I went and then got my master's degree in pastoral counseling and went to seminary, and God put me on that path. But when I look back at that, I think, you know what? I was kind of on the right track. I liked teaching, right? I knew that part. And God transformed part of that desire and sanctified me and let me know, like, you like teaching, but you just don't have the thing that you need to teach little kids. You have something that's better for adults. And so over time, God sanctified that desire. So long story short, seek the Lord with all your heart and allow him to transform you into what he wants you to be. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, and you might want to tap the bell as well. That way, every time I make a new video, you'll get notified and you won't miss any of the new content I'm putting out every single week. I'm Mark from ApplyGodsWord.com. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and God bless.